behalf of me and Kamala, I would like to say thank you to everybody who's been working on this record and supporting it. We're very excited that it's coming out.
It's wonderful to know that their legacies will continue on through this music, this beautiful music. I know that Mulgrew loved playing with Roy Hargrove. He would get a smile inside whenever he played with someone he enjoyed playing with.
Hi, I'm Zev Feldman, co-producer of In Harmony, the new release from the great Roy Hargrove and Mulgrew Miller. It's a pleasure to talk about this release. It's been quite an extraordinary journey to get here. Our story first began back in the spring of 2016. I was visiting record producer and label executive Groovin' High Records founder Jacques Moual at his home in Geneva, Switzerland. Jacques played me this music for the first time, and I was absolutely taken by this music.
Hearing Mulgrew's artistry in the drummerless context is a very interesting and poetic thing. The two concerts that are documented here, one from 2006 and one from 2007, both of them were unrehearsed, they were extemporaneous, and they knew what to do, and they unleashed their creativity on this material.
Roy Hargrove was definitely one of the greatest, most influential trumpet players of any era. His influence went far beyond just our generation.
Roy Hargrove is the trumpet king, trumpet legend. For my generation of players, and I could appreciate who he was as an artist because he was young. He was a young black dude who had swag, but at the same time was killing it, was burning.
You could hear Roy on a quintet record. You could hear him on a record with musicians from Havana and Cuba. You could hear him on a record with D'Angelo or Erykah Badu playing neo-soul or new age kind of funk music. Or you could hear him creating his own music.
He probably knew every song ever written. He paid so much homage to the history, but yet at the same time, he's playing on hip hop albums. You know, he's playing with Common, he's playing with D'Angelo. He was so fluid musically in that way, and he respected all the music, you know, in its highest form.
Working with Roy for me was, it wasn't one time, it was many times. But when you knew you were getting Roy on your song, it just, you knew it was just gonna turn out to be something very soulful.
Roy's the gold standard in sound, in harmonic conception, in delivery of the music, in terms of community, his band conception, all of that is what makes Roy what Roy is.
He's one of the most authentic people slash performer slash entertainer that I'd ever seen in concert and really admired. It's so unique because like some people just don't have that ability to kind of get up on stage and be authentic and it be so damn cool.
Clearly he was a wonderful player and the scene misses him. He reminded me like of an advanced, an aged, as a positive sense, Clifford Brown. He had a good sense of harmony, played in tune.
I learned a lot from him and the sensitivity that he played with as well. It's like playing with a singer, you know, playing ballads, and his voice on his horn was just so beautiful.
The fact that we were really good friends and we came on the scene at the same time, that doesn't cloud my judgment. I know he's one of the baddest cats to ever put a horn to his lips.
What was it like playing duos with Mulgrew?
For me, it was a great learning experience. I had so much respect for him as a musician and as a human being, you know, and I think that's one of the things that made it work so well.
Mulgrew was someone who had his own sound and own style. Mulgrew had that in spades. He was a real example of mentorship. He looked at me and it was just so much compassion. Later he told me just he loved to see young black musicians trying to swing, especially on the piano. He's like, if you're trying to do that, I'm your biggest supporter.
Mulgrew was very special to me. He was a nice cat, reeked with humility, as incredible as a player that he was.
Mulgrew had a way of bringing that soulful kind of gospel feel in with the sophisticated elements of harmonic conception that we all know that are in jazz.
What was it like playing with him? Well, of playing with Herbie Hancock. I played with Herbie first, but Mulgrew was really at the top of the list.
I heard him play. We became good friends. There was an appreciation of his enormous talent. It's his enormous gift.
There's this language that he has that no other piano player has. Mogul literally had his own language. There are things that Mogul can play, or some, not even Mogul doesn't have to, he didn't have to play it. Somebody else can play it, and you can be like, oh, that's Mogul stuff.
Just sit down and listen to the sound that Mogul gets from the piano. It just fills the instrument. He plays the whole key range. He plays in all the keys. He plays great notes. He has a great sound of the instrument.
They were both students of the music. They, you could tell they enjoyed playing together and not trying to prove something individually, but making music and responding to each other.
These two are two of the most important musicians of the last 50 years.
When the music is at a complex level, how to still make it emotional and accessible to someone who doesn't know anything about the complexities of what they're doing. These are things that they had going musically that influenced me.
There's folks like Mulgrew and Roy that expand the territory of what this music delivers to the world. It's important for us to remember that this music was born on this soil through a great deal of pain, turned to triumph.
And this project is incredible, it's beautiful, it's blessed.
I just want us to be able to listen to this music, feel the inspiration, and just help celebrate the legacies of these two gentlemen.